Hello and welcome again to River Valley Farm. We're getting closer on this 300. Hopefully it's not 300 problems, but if it is, it is. So, let's see. I left you last. We pulled the distributor off. And we were going to work on that thing. Well, I went ahead and off camera stripped it down just so I wouldn't have to bore you to death with parts and pieces and whatnot. So anyway, there's no real slack from this piece to this gear here. The slack that I'm getting is in my timing advance. Stand up there, you son of a buck. There we go. So anyway. Dropping everything today. So the slack I'm getting is in my timing advance here. I figured out a way I could show you all this, but anyway. So that's the slack, that's what I'm getting as far as rotation is concerned, is that. But you know, without the thing running, with the thing running, the weights are going to be swung out, so it should be, yeah. How's that work? The weights are out. Yeah, if the weights are out, then the timing's going to be, is it advanced or backed off? I don't remember. But anyway, whatever. So that's basically what that is. Was it running? It should not. The weights are going to be out. As I was saying, the weights are going to be out, so it's not going to allow this to move. So that piece should be okay. This up and down motion that it has, I don't really know what we can do about that other than just not worry about it. So that's what we're going to do with that. Just for argument's sake, what I've already done, is so I took and made sure that we were at number one top dead center compression stroke. Okay. Made sure. Double dog sure that we were at number one top dead center compression stroke. I think it was 180 out. I'm hopeful it was 180 out. We'll see. But I hope that's all that was wrong with it. That's all that is wrong with it, I should say. But anyway, in order to check timing, we put number one on compression stroke. Both of the valves, intake valve and exhaust valve, are loose. And then took the spark plug out. And, well, if I had my light, and then I can look in there and actually see the top of the piston move up into the combustion chamber. So, yeah, anyway, like I said, I can actually see it move up there, stop, and then start back down. So then we turn it back the other way in a little bit, and there you go. You're pretty much right where you need to be. Or close enough that we shouldn't have to worry with it too much. So anyway, on course for getting it to run, I don't think we really need to mess with this too much. I don't feel anything that seems outlandish as far as valve lash is concerned or anything like that, so I think we're just going to let that alone. I got to put the distributor back together, obviously, and put it back on and then see what happens. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this piece on, put new grease in here, put this piece on, get my whatever you want to call it, the dog that goes in here, set and where I want it to be. Then we'll put the actual distributor in and get lined up to where it would point at number one here on the distributor cap. And then we'll see what happens. If it still doesn't run, I don't know what happened to it. But anyway, we're going to find out. Okay, so we got the distributor drive back on. Again, it was a little bit of trouble getting it lined up, but whatever, that happens sometimes, right? Things don't line up quite right, so you make it fit gently. So next up, make our way through the maze, and we got to put this plate back in the distributor. Well, we got to put the actual distributor back together. So bear with me while I do that. Alright, so we've got our distributor back on. I'm only going to put one hole down on it for now in case we got to pull it back out. It is approximately, by looking at the rotor, it's approximately in the right position. So let's find out. But I still got to put more pieces back on first, like the coil. All right, so now we are put back together. Everything looks like it should be. I put this gauge on the oil pressure so we can see what we got there. Should it start, we will at least be able to see if we have oil pressure, right? Maybe even if it doesn't start. Still not looking very good, but anyway, I do still have fuel in there, so that's good. And then turn the choke on, see what happens. And now I think I'm gonna have to change batteries. Anyway, we should have gas. You sorry son of a bitch. Anyway. It was coughing a little bit out the exhaust even, so we're getting closer. And I got fuel running out the carburetor, so it's got to be getting gas. I mean, right? Let's see. One more try here. Choke it. I guess we'll have to put a starter ring gear in this thing eventually. Out of smelling salts. Good smelling salts, anyway. Yeah. Anyway. It lives, sort of. I need to make some adjustments, obviously. But it runs. It runs. Let's see. That's not right at all.
So yeah, it looks like we're gonna pull the distributor out and re-clock it, but anyway. It must be off a tooth or something. Pretty good, or well, yeah, we're idling okay. Sounds a little funky, but you know, show me one that doesn't, I guess. He thought it would never run for us. Anyway, I don't think, we're definitely gonna have to go back and retime the distributor because I don't like that. But everything else. Kind of rich at a high idle too, but you know, not bad. I've been adjusting on the carburetor and stuff, trying to tinker and get it lined out and not to be burning quite so rich, but anyway, I think we got it. Let's see if it'll start back. It should, but let's see. So let's give it a little bit of throttle, not a lot, but a little bit, and then well, then there's that thing again, but you know, no hill for a climber. Might be too much of a hill for the starter, but anyway. Pretty as you please, other than the Bendix on the starter and maybe the ring gear on the flywheel. I guess I should really clean it off and go for a drive and make sure things like the gears work and whatnot. One thing that I did not see, but I wish that I had seen before I bought the thing, is this. The PTO won't shut off because that's broke off. So anyway, another minor issue. But it runs. Now we need to see if it drives. Okay, we are aboard. There's first gear. What was that I just ran over? Oh, a lid. Okay. First gear works. reverse gear works. Mosquito fogger works. Let's see, we did first, so let's try our second gear. That works. Third gear, that works. 30 pounds oil pressure, that ain't bad. Fourth gear, that works. Clutch might need tinkered with a little bit, but it ain't bad. Hey, everything works. I can't say I'm shocked, but anyway, everything works, right? So, yeah. I guess next up be to put the alternator on it, change the engine oil, and I don't know what else, but anyway, something. Probably put it to work, see what happens. Make sure everything's gonna work out all right. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back later.